Let me show the audience our
Doritos
and Barrelitos. Two Sody Pops. Turn around, got a nice picture on it. Three jars.
Very nice.
With your head.
Very nice.
Mexican Sody Pop from the Mexican store. Imported straight from Mexico. And here's a Mexican squirt bottle with all the nice ripple ridges on it when you drink this one.
Curvy.
You can use this one for a good old butt plug. You'll like this one, Bishop. It reminds us of our favorite friend, the chicken.
Cook brand.
No, not cook.
Cock brand.
Yes, that's more like it.
Cock brand. What is it?
It's cock brand.
Honey drink?
The chicken. Honey herbal jelly drink. Look, it's like all gooey and stuff.
Does chicken actually drink that?
Chicken lays this stuff. Gets it out of that feisty egg layer of his. And you know, I have a Salvation Army box of lovers as opposed to... Hey, Bishop, you know what I got in here?
What?
Not only do I have food products, I got dope products for your ears. Music. What this is? It's your favorite one. I got it for you in a discount bin.
What?
It's a dollar. It's a dollar in Boston. A CD.
Oh my god. It's my army of lovers. Around the world, around the world.
I've got a Salvation Army box of lovers, and they bring me all these good gifts.
Oh, this proves the superiority of the jukebox over MTV, because MTV won't play Army of Lovers, the best video ever made.
Will they play Too Large by the Deaf Dames?
I don't think so.
They do a remake. Oh, this one was 88 cents. You see, there's an 8.
Wow.
There's the other 8.
And worth every penny.
This is from some record store called Sounds in New York City. See, 88 cents. It's all worth, too. It's this attempt at a rap record by these two hype sisters here. And they redo that Devo classic, Whip It. Griffiths bought the 12-inch single, but he paid $2 for that thing, and I only paid 88 cents for the CD. Then again, you try to outdo Ski Mask and you can't.
Word.
Around the world, oh boy. Oh, here we go.
Star fruit. Fruit tree?
Star fruit, yeah.
This is some sort of unidentifiable fruit.
The delicious fruit.
It is a delicious fruit, but I don't know what it is.
It's Motley Crue fruit, because it's a star, like a pentagram.
Wow.
Who do you suppose is more evil? Is it Rush, because they have those pentagrams on their drums and on the bass? Or is it Motley Crue, because they have them on these, like, comedy tragedy masks at their proverbial theater of pain?
I don't know. That's a tough one. I'd have to say Rush.
What do you suppose Theater of Pain is about? Is it about the show place, or is it about Super Save Rate Cinemas, where there's all sorts of fights, I guess? Actually, I haven't heard if there's any fights there, but the kind of people that hang out there, I think there would be. All these kids with their dope Raiders jackets and stuff. And we got alcoholic beverages here. Yeah. 301 Original Bull Shooters Beer. Hey, look, that's one of our production assistants on the label.
Mr. Mike.
Hey, it's Mr. Mike's Light Ale.
Wow.
Oh boy.
Mike Brown.
Now, I'm gonna bust up the monotony. Hopefully we got a film now, some sort.
With their mothers and fathers. They look at the horse, and I said to the horse, do you like these little kids? And he goes, like that. His music out of the grill. Down here, the music. City Rabbit.
It's the honor of the heart, baby. Right, then everybody say, oh, James kissed Nancy. James kissed Nancy. And everybody will laugh at you. You put the boxing gloves on and box, you know what I mean? And all that there. Oh, and you thought I felt good. I didn't need no cocaine. And I'm 54 years old, I don't need no cocaine, I feel good, you know? Like, sometimes I feel like I'm 17 years old. You don't need dope. You know, just take care of your body. I'm a diabetic. I gotta take a needle 2 times a day. I had a heart attack 4 years ago. But I'm still here, and I feel good. See? You can't give up. You don't give up. You see what I'm saying? I can have another heart attack, I don't even feel like I had one. I had a major heart attack. I was in intensive care for 11 days. I'm on pills. I gotta take pills for my heart, pills for my blood pressure. And I'm a diabetic. But see, I exercise, still exercise. That helped me. And that's why I feel good. I don't feel like I'm taking needles. I don't feel like I had a heart attack. And I'm ready. And you know, I always be ready. You know what I mean? As long as I keep with the doctor telling me what to do and listen to him, I'm gonna do it. But if I cook dope, I'd be, you know, oh, what did you say? What? You know. Yeah. Where? Where are you coming from? Yeah. You know, that's cocaine and all that, right? They don't know where they are. I love the hooker. I love the dope addict. I love everybody, like the Lord loves, you know. Then we take a nice shower. How do you feel? 16 years old, huh? Oh, man, wonderful. I'll sit in the steam room. You ever go in the steam room? You sweat. You feel good. Then after you exercise, you go in the steam room. Then you take a nice shower. You walk out that door. Hey, who wants me? You know? I'm not on dope. I feel good. Can I work out? I went in the steam room. I feel wonderful. Who wants me? See? That's how you feel. You know what I mean? Your body ain't to take punishment. Your body is not to take cocaine. You know, your body ain't taking speed, supposed to take speed. Anything you do to your body that hurt it, drinking, being an alcoholic, you're ruining our body, you're ruining it. You're gonna get sick, you're gonna feel rotten. Now I know you, like I'm saying, if the car wasn't like that, and really, everybody calls me Elvis on the road. I don't look nothing like the guy. I'm not like that. You know what I mean? But sometimes I back up. They say, can you move like him? You know, I go like this, you know. Try and move like him, you know. Elvis Presley sitting in that car. I met him in 1969. And when I box, you know, I go like this, you know. You know, and I love all this here, you know. And I like Elvis, you know. The way he was good to people, bought people brand new cars. You know what I mean? The guy had a heart of gold. And you guys got a heart of gold, and I love you all.
Thanks,
James.
Thanks.
Take it easy. Well, I see you.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
Take it easy now.
But he's gonna recreate that one someday for the show. He's forgotten the logistic coordinates of that grave, but so be it. Here we go. Disco to the King by Douglas Roy. You know what Disco to the King is? Not that King video we showed, but look, it's Elvis. See Elvis? That's great. Look at the label. It's on Smash Disco Records. It's a French Quebecois label. Of course, Americans say French-Canadian, but it's really Quebecois is the correct term. I finally found out when I went up there. Sam gave me any education in this country. I don't like that derogatory French-Canadian term being used for people in Quebec, because it's not right. But it should be Disco Smash, with the Smash Disco. They were like sort of foretelling their future when like all those awful white hard rock stations decided to like Smash Disco. I think it's got Tootie Fruity. That's a Little Richard song. Hound Dog. Don't Be Cruel. Hey, it's a Cheap Trick song. What's that doing on here? Teddy Bear. I hate teddy bears. Too many people collect those things. What's wrong with stuffed alligators or fish? Jailhouse Rock. Huh, man, that's what Mike Tyson's doing right now. It's Now or Never. Too Much. Heartbreak Hotel. That's near the Thunderbird Hotel. Love Me Tender. That's about S&M. Blue Suede Shoes. It's about what Gersetz wears. That's When the Heartaches Begin. I'm All Shook Up. I Want You, I Need You. Rip It Up. What You Should Do When You Get the Latest Issue of the Riverside Review or Art Voice. And Falling in Love. Falling in Love. Oh shit. If you hang out at your local bar, and most you probably do if you watch this show, you should go down there and request them to put on Channel 32 Friday at 8:30. Make sure that everyone gets to see this wonderful show. What the heck else are they going to show? The Sabres losing again? Why watch that when you can watch these winning records? Look. It's the Disco Devil. Like the Dirt Devil. Oh boy. It's on K-Tel. K-Polytel. K Polytechnic Institute, Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute. Hey, look. Look at this lineup here. I don't know who this guy is. We got Ronnie Jones. My dream girl over here, Donna Summer. One of my all-time favorite mentors, the Barry White. Claudia Berry. I think it's Chuck Berry's daughter. Toulouse. And Shadow Lane. Man, look at that dumpy broad. It's like Charlene Tilton or something. Charlene Tilton was disgusting. Remember her in Dallas? Oh, God, she was ugly. I don't know why she was a sex symbol. Huh. She's an argument against sex. We got... Oh, wow. House of the Rising Sun is on here by Revelation. Like the record company from New York City. It puts out Bold and Judge. And all those records that are like worth $100 to like skinheads, but they're really lame New York City hardcore boring, real boring records. Oh, wow. They even made this song listenable. Santa Esmeralda. I have one of their albums. They do a version of this. My house in New Orleans. Is that where David Duke lives? The Sun, next to the Weekly World News. Ruin, like Greece. Like the paintings in the Olympic restaurant on the wall. Oh man, that's an art gallery and a half. We got Morris Jefferson, like Jefferson Avenue. Spank Your Blank Blank. It's a great record, look at that. Look at that big hand there spanking her butt in those like tight, unwashed, blue, stiff, McCrory's designer fake Jordache jeans. Man,